Okay, students, so we'll go for second problem over DFA. Draw a DFA to accept strings of A's and B's with at least one A. Okay, so in previous question, what we had, we had only one A. Okay, so the input string were consisting of alphabet A itself. Okay, but here we got A's and B's exactly. But just observe, here we got two different alphabets. Sigma will be equal to A comma B because it is mentioning. See, draw a DFA to accept strings of A's and B's. Okay. So in our example, now instead of only A, okay, we'll be facing B also. Okay. But what is the condition with at least one A itself? So the minimum requirement of this DFA is again single A. Remember, okay, the minimum requirement of this particular DFA is single A. What is the length of that minimum requirement? Length of that single A is 1. Okay, so if I consider n is equal to 1, 1 plus 1 state we need. So how many states we are expecting? Again, 2 states only. Okay, so we'll begin with, so Q naught we have, right? I'm making it as start state. Okay, so later Q1 we have. Okay, we'll see whether we need to make it as final state or what. Okay, so now at least one A we have. So obviously we will draw a transition from Q naught on receiving A to Q1 exactly. So if I want to make this single A to be accepted by this DFA, then obviously I need to make Q1 as a final state. Okay, then any pattern of string, okay, if it is having single A, it will be accepted. Okay, example of strings are, okay, see, just observe, example of strings are single A, if we have, it should be accepted. Okay, then apart from this, any other possibilities of these kind of string? Okay, double A, if we have, it should be accepted, right? Double A, if we have, it should be accepted, right? Then just observe this BAA, if you're having BAA, whether it should be accepted, rejected, observe it carefully. A and B combination we may have. Okay, what is the condition? At least one A it should be. Whether this string is beginning with A or whether this string is like ending with B, okay, we don't have that condition. Okay, anything it may be, does not matter. Remember, clear. Or we may be having a condition like A, B, B, B also, or else A, B also possible. Okay, why? The condition is it must consist of only one A. Okay, at least one A. So not only one A, at least one A. Okay, then these are the possible string, okay, using alphabet A comma B, what we can generate, right? So we'll see, okay, whether our DFA, whatever we are designing over here, whether it will be able to accept all these pattern or what. Okay, first we'll check for the minimum requirement. Q naught on receiving A, it will come for Q1. I made Q1 as a final state. Yes, it will be accepted. Okay, then what about this double A? What about this double A? See here, Q naught on receiving A, okay, fine, it will come for Q1. Okay, so now we don't have a transition for that second A. Okay, so obviously we can provide it for a self loop, right? A, I can label it as, okay, then second pattern will be accepted. But here in this question, the possible strings or the pattern of string, okay, may begin with B also, right? Okay, the condition is what? At least one A. See, in this third one, what we have, BAA, it is beginning with A, it is beginning with B and followed by number of A's. Okay, then it should also be accepted. Is it right? Okay, but whether we are having any transition for B inside a state Q1, sorry, and Q0 and Q1 in both. Okay, we don't have a transition. So what we will do, okay, so whenever a string begin with B, okay, so your machine should stay in Q0 itself. Remember this, okay. Why it is so? After B, if it get A, then only it should go for final state. If you are having double B only, okay, then we don't have a single A, right? We don't have a at least one A concept in this question, okay, or in this particular string. This should be rejected. So what we need to do is, okay, if a string is beginning with B, then it should remain in Q0 itself, okay, until it find at least one A, it should not move towards the Q1. Okay, then double B, if you are having, you will be in Q0 itself, it will be rejected, right? Then if you are having double B A, whether it will be accepted or rejected, observe it carefully. First time it will be in Q0 itself, second time also it will be in Q0 itself, but when it receive A, okay, then it will change its state from Q0 to Q1, means moving towards the final state, it will be accepted. Clear? Okay, now we are done with, okay, a string which is beginning with A, after that following a single A or double A, such kind of string pattern over there. Now, we'll discuss about A followed by B. Okay, see, initially if you are receiving A, then Q0 will change its state from Q0 to Q1. Okay, so it is in final state. Now, if you are having series of B, okay, do we have any transition for B over here? Okay, or backwards or forward, anything? No, we don't have. But we have a transition for A exactly. Okay, if this is what the pattern, okay, whether it should be accepted or rejected, it should be accepted. Remember, because A we are having already, it is followed by B. Okay, then here what we need to do, A or B we need to provide. Okay, after encountering single A, whether you are receiving A or B, your machine which should stay in final state itself. Then A, B, B, B will be accepted. See here, first A, you are entering for Q1, then later B, later B, later B, total three Bs. Where you are staying now, you will be in Q1 itself. Okay, then later, one more pattern we are having. A, B, A, B if you are having. Okay, or else B, A, B, A if you are having. Okay, then what it will be? Okay, we'll check for these two conditions. A, B, A, B if you are having. Observe it carefully. When I receive A, Q0 to Q1 it will be. Okay, transition will be from Q0 to Q1. Then what I have? B I am having. Okay, so you'll be in Q1 itself. Okay, later what you have? A you are having. Okay, then later you will be in Q1 itself. At last you are having B, you'll be in Q1 itself. So this particular string will be accepted. Then what about this last one? Okay, B, A, B, A you are having. When I receive B, you will be in start state itself. After that we have one, A. So you are moving towards the final state. Okay, so this is what the transition, B, A over. Then later, again B you are having, okay, so you'll be in Q1 itself, okay, and again one more A you are having, you'll be in Q1 itself. So this states A or B, okay, A or B, if you are having, you'll be in Q1 itself. That is what the meaning of this particular DFA is, okay? Okay, fine. So apart from this, so we got to know, like, for this particular question, this DFA, what we are designing over here, okay, this holds good. Exactly, okay, because it is accepting all the varieties of string pattern, okay. So later, what I need to do, I need to go for designing the machine. Is it right? M will be equal to Q comma sigma comma delta comma Q naught, then later final state F exactly, right? Okay, then Q will be equal to what? Please adjust with the handwriting, okay, because I'm drawing it from mouse exactly. Okay, fine. So Q0 comma Q1. Is it right? We got only two states over here, Q0 and Q1. That's why Q will be equal to Q0 and Q1. Okay, then what about sigma? Be careful, students. Now the sigma will be equal to A comma B, right? Sigma will be equal to A comma B. Clear? Okay, then next. Like what is the start state exactly? Start state is Q0. As usual, Q0 is the start. Okay? Q0 is the start state. Okay, then final state will be what? Final state is equal to, yes, Q1. Right? Okay. Now, when it comes for transition delta, observe it carefully. Okay? Delta. Okay? See? For Q0, there are two transitions, right? One is for A and one is for B. Let me consider A first, okay? So Q0 on receiving A, okay? Where it is making a move? Towards the Q1, right? Okay, then later. Second, B with Q0 itself, because we are not yet done with Q0. Okay, Q0 on receiving B, okay? Where you'll be? You'll be in Q0 itself, right? Q0 on receiving B. Then what I left with? I left with Q1, okay? So delta of Q1, sorry, okay, Q1 comma A, okay, will be equal to Q1 itself. Remember, this is A or B. First you need to write for A, then later you need to write for B, okay? Fine, remember this, okay? Then delta of Q1 on receiving B, okay, where you are going? Inside Q1 itself, okay? So this is what the complete answer for this particular question. So apart from this, We can draw the transition table also. Fine. So Q naught, Q1. So here we got delta. Okay. A we got and B we got. Okay. Delta of Q naught on A. Observe it carefully. Delta of Q naught on A. We are going for Q1. Okay. Then later second delta of Q naught comma B. Okay. You'll be in Q naught itself. Then later delta of Q1 comma A. You'll be in Q1 itself. Okay. Delta of Q1 comma B. You'll be in Q1 itself. Okay. So in the previous problem, I forgot to mention the start state and the final state in the transition table. Okay. Just correct it. Okay. So the start state should be identified by an arrow mark in our transition table, and final state should be identified by a star mark as a pointer. Okay, in your final state. Okay, so this is what your final state. So this is what the complete solution for this particular DFA. Thank you, students. Okay, in next video we will solve question number 3.